Guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. This is Bella with Bella and the Phoenix. Sorry that I've been gone for a minute. I took another hiatus. It's just been crazy. Like, this year has been insane, and I can't believe today is New Year's Eve. So happy New Year's Eve to you guys. Happy New Year if you're watching this on New Year's. But yeah, I've been working and doing my own personal readings for my clients, and it has been so hectic, but just wanted to come on here today and do a reading for the collective for you guys. We're just going to check on what's going on with the divine masculine, especially with this Venus retrograde and the new moon here is in about 2 days, new moon in Capricorn. And also I think Mercury's in the shadow period, so things are very hectic right now, you know, astrology wise, energy wise, and yeah, so let's go ahead and find out what is going on with the divine masculine and see where it goes. Towards the end, I'm going to pull some initials and months, that way I can kind of give you an idea if this is specifically for a particular person, or it doesn't have to be geared towards anybody in particular, but it could be confirmation for some of you guys. All right, spirit, so hope you guys are doing well, and let's get to it. So what is going on, spirit, with the collective, with the divine masculines? What is the overall message here for the reading? Okay, so we have deep sea, or deep dark sea mermaid. Find solutions in the unknown places in the darkness, and strange companions in stranger places. Challenges, use your imagination. Wow, so I'm getting here that right now the collective, the divine masculines, are going through a really dark time. I just feel like it's kind of like dark night of the soul vibes. A lot of things that are deep down in the depths of their subconscious are coming up. And so I feel like they're trying to find a solution to this darkness, you know, to try to find the positive in the darkness. And then right here is just saying this might be like a strange situation that this masculine finds himself in. But I feel like spirit is letting him know that he needs to just think outside the box and be more positive, because if you're already in a negative space and you keep thinking negative, that's when you stay stuck, you know. So I feel like this is basically what spirit is saying for the reading. Like, I feel like they're in a dark space right now, but they're going to come out of that and use their imagination, you know, just really manifest something better than where they're at. Beauty and the Beast. You need some space in a relationship. So for some of you, if you're dealing with a masculine that's in a third party connection with the karmic, I feel like this relationship is making them feel like this is a challenge that they're trying to find a solution out of, you know, to come out of that dark tunnel. And you know, with the number 8 here, this is like a cycle, right? So this is a cycle. The 16 reminds me of the tower, and 28 here breaks down to a 10. So I feel like this person is realizing that they're at the end of a situation that they know they need to come out with a solution, and it involves having space from somebody, like just really breaking away from being with a karmic connection. Okay. Very interesting. Look at that. Underneath that was dragonfly mermaid. You've attracted wonderful news. This is the sun's energy. We have a dragonfly here. Dragonflies are about transparency, transformation. So, oh man, I feel like they're coming out of this darkness and realizing that they're in a strange land. I feel like they know that they're not where they're supposed to be. You know what I mean? And they're trying to picture what their life would look like if they were around people where they feel they belong. For example, with the divine feminine. Let's see what the romance angels want to say to start off before we go into the tarot. What else do we need to know, spirit? Wow, we got three cards that came out right away. So we got finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. Okay. Oh, release your ex. Holy crap. The time has come to clear your energy. And it's no accident that came out with this stranger companions. I feel like this masculine feels this person that he's connected to is a stranger to him now. And now he knows that he needs to release this person because they've gotten as far as they're going to go. And it involves finances and career. Maybe they're married and they know that they're going to have to take a hit financially if they're going through a divorce. Wow, look at that. Codependency. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. So I feel like this person is realizing that they're in a codependent relationship and they need space. They need space from this codependent karmic. And they themselves could be codependent as well. Look at that, because they're wanting to go towards their true love. This is a romance of a lifetime. So everything here that spirit is saying is indicative of letting us know that your person is starting to finally dig deeper on why they're holding on to a connection. Is it for money, you know, or are they holding on because they're thinking it's going to get better? And the more they hold on, the more the darker it gets. You know, there's no optimistic outcome to the situation but to release that person and clear their energy. Because when you're with somebody that's very toxic, you know, that affects your energy as well. And so if that person they're with is very negative, they're going to automatically feel that negative energy, and it's going to affect them to where they're going to be negative. So this has a lot to do with breaking free of codependency, because it is an addiction. You know, sometimes when you are in that cycle, because we saw the number 8 earlier, you don't realize that you are in that repetitive cycle of relying on somebody for your happiness. And this situation does not look very good. Okay, let's get one more before we go into the tarot. Show the world the real you. Full moon in Aquarius. Okay, and Aquarius season is right around the corner. So I'm getting here that spirit is urging this masculine to really reveal how they really feel and not hide in it anymore, because I feel like they've been hiding. Yeah, see? Your commitment is being tested. So spirit is saying, how committed are you to being authentic to yourself and whoever you come in contact with? Because if you're not being committed to being the best you, then you can't be upset with yourself or anybody, because you're not doing what you need to do to be true to yourself. You're lying to yourself if you're thinking this situation can get better, or if you're holding on due to finances. Because, you know, when you hold on to finances and career, like, you're putting too much emphasis on those things come and go. And sometimes spirit has to shake up your world to show you that you don't need those things to make up who you are, or you don't need those things to find validation or value or your self-worth in those things. So it's getting to the point where this masculine is realizing that those things that he's been holding on to, it doesn't have any weight anymore. And I feel like with finances, you know, the more you hold on to something, the more you jeopardize it, right? The more you force things and it just doesn't happen the way it needs to, because you're trying to be in control. And I feel like this masculine is trying to hold on to things that are materialistic, but at the end of the day, it's not worth to holding on. You know, it's not worth holding on to those things. Okay, bottom of the deck here, we have the Empress. Okay, because I'm getting here, like, they're starting to realize that once they come out of this dark phase, that they're going to realize there's more abundance out there that's available to them, and they don't have to hold on to what the money that they have, because money comes and goes. And if you devote your time and energy on things that bring you happiness and you're happy and you're passionate, then money's going to follow soon after that. You know what I mean? You can start over from scratch. I've had to start over from scratch, you know? Like a lot of us do. So, let me just leave this up here. Okay. All right. So, Spirit, let's find out what's going on with the masculine and his energy. What a way to start the reading, though, right? Okay. Wow. And this deck is not in reverse, you guys. So, we have the Page of Swords in reverse and the Lovers in reverse, okay? So I'm getting here that somebody is really constantly thinking about ending something, because we have a skull here on that flag. And this is about somebody not wanting to communicate that they know something is over. Wow. Yeah, see? Bottom of the deck, we have the Page of Cups. So I feel like your person is starting to realize that they have been very immature, because both of these are pages and they're not growing to their true potential. Yeah, see, now we have another childish energy here, Six of Cups. Usually it's little kids in the Rider-Waite, so in this one it's a little different, but I feel like your person is thinking about the past and how their childhood wounds could have affected the person that they ended up choosing. Yeah, look at that. Ace of Wands. Because I feel like this had to do with something where there wasn't a lot of emotions tied to it. It was more desire, like, you know, like lust type of energy. And sometimes masculines, you know, get caught up in that type of energy where they think lust is love and it's not, you know. And at least for women, we know the difference. Like, we're very in tune with our emotions, and we can tell the difference when we're lusting after somebody and that energy wears out, you know? So I feel like this is our lesson that they're learning. Look at that. We got the Seven of Cups, the Knight of Pentacles, and the title card. So, yeah, I feel like this masculine is thinking about the option that he chose, somebody that he chose that he's not happy with, that he's ready to part ways from. Knight of Pentacles, this is somebody that is slowly making their way to their feminine. Look at that. Right when I'm saying that, Eight of Cups at the bottom. So this person is ready to move on. And Six of Cups is about a reunion, somebody that's coming back from your past. Yeah, look at the overall energy here at the bottom is Eight of Swords. Somebody's ready to break free from their negative ways of thinking. We started off the reading with that dark energy. They're in this dark night of the soul energy. But they're ready to start fresh here with the Ace of Wands. Let's just get some clarifiers here. Why is the Page of Swords here in reverse, Spirit? Queen of Wands. So it could be you, Divine Feminine. You could be somebody that works out a lot. You could be a fire sign, or you could just be somebody that works in general, like you work a lot. But your person can't stop thinking about you with the Page of Swords in reverse. They're like obsessively thinking about you. And yeah, it's like they're not letting you know this either with the Hermits at the bottom. Okay, why is the Lovers here in reverse? And with the Page of Swords in reverse, it's like they're not telling you, you know? Confirmed by the Hermit, they're not telling you that they're very attracted to you. They find you very strong, especially with that Leo energy. Wow, speaking of Leo energy, here's the Sun. So I get here that your person wants to take action towards your connection because you guys are not talking right now. Or if you are, it's very little communication. We have birds here, you know, so it's like this is a communication that's coming in from both sides. You could end up having a child with this person, or maybe you do already. We have the star here at the bottom, the constellations. So I feel like you guys are destined to be together. And I feel like with this separation, your person is realizing that you're their sun. You're their sunshine. You're the person that makes them really happy. And they're ready to take action to leave whoever they're with. Because the lovers is also about a separation, a divorce, somebody that's not choosing to be with somebody anymore. Why is the Page of Cups here? Wow, this kind of came off to the side. Justice and the King of Swords. Somebody's cutting somebody off. Okay. I've seen it before where King of Swords represents divorce. Because, you know, he's cutting somebody off. And this particular deck is interesting because there's two hearts here. So I feel like your person is torn between you and the person that they're committed to. And they could have gone to counseling with that person. But at the end of the day, it's like they still feel like you're the one that brings them balance, brings them back into balance where they're able to be stable with you. And they feel out of balance without you. Wow, speaking of balance here, we have the Chariot. You balance your person out, okay? It's like where you are able to stay calm, your person might be a little bit more aggressive, and you're able to help them come back down from that energy because you guys complement each other. And the dogs here represent like loyalty. So I just feel like your person feels that they were very immature when they were with you, and now they're realizing with the King of Swords that they're getting clarity about the situation that they're in with the karmic contract, because justice is also about soul contract. And so I feel like your person is realizing that they need to end this contract, you know, cut it off with the King of Swords. Why is the Six of Cups here, Spirit? Ace of Pentacles. So, I mean, that's definitely about a solid offer in the physical world. And interesting because she's also holding water here. And this person is holding flowers. So I feel like your person is going to come in from the past, reconcile with you, and give you an offer that's going to be very emotional, very healing, and very prosperous because of it's a flower that's been blooming. They want to offer you something in the physical world. Yeah, look at that. Speaking of which, we have the Six of Pentacles. They really want to give equal give and take with you. And on this stage it says love more. They want to love you more than what they've been showing you. Wow. Why is the Ace of Wands here? The Four of Cups. Okay. This is like somebody at a New Year's party. And it's interesting because, you know, we have New Year's tonight. Your person could be with this karma on New Year's and they're not happy. They have a desire to start over with you. And they're just like, if this is him, this is like him just drinking away. And this is like the karma. Like you can tell they're not even like looking at each other. They're just there. So this connection has fizzled out and your person is bored, honestly. Yeah, look at that. Why would I say that? This person is ready to end this connection with the Death card. Bunch of butterflies here. You know, there needs to be some kind of change that needs to take place. There's a little scythe here that, you know, cutting somebody off. So that's what's happening right now with this masculine's energy. Let me know if this resonates in the comments below. Okay. Why is the Seven of Cups here, Spirit? strength card. Okay. So yeah, your person is finally coming to terms with wanting to be united with you. You know, like this gives me very family vibes since we have a whole lion family here and the giraffes in the background. I feel like when this person fantasizes who they want to be with, they think about you because they want to build a family with you. Yeah, see, the Queen of Cups, that's you. So I feel like when your person thinks about all these options that they've entertained, and when they think about a family life, they don't see anybody else but you. Okay, that's beautiful. Why is Nine of Pentacles here, Spirit, with the title card? I also get here with the horse. You know, the horse is behind this, the fence here. I feel like your person wants to break free. And this title card reminds, you know, I usually consider this one as like the karmic energy or wanting to be official. So I feel like your person wants to break away from this karmic, especially since it's right underneath the Justice and the King of Swords and the Page of Cups. So why is Nine of Pentacles here with the karmic energy? We have the Hierophant, Ace of Cups, and Seven of Pentacles. Wow. So, as you know, Hierophant usually in tarot means commitment, a spiritual awakening, you know, breaking away from old beliefs, tradition. This actually has to do with Egypt, so like past life energy. So I feel like for some of you, you could have had a past life with this person, and they want to break free because they want to start over with you with the Ace of Cups. It's like they're finally realizing that you're the one they've had a past life connection with, and this is why you guys are so connected. And look at this, Seven of Pentacles is somebody that's on their knees like, please take me back. And you're not facing them right now because there's a lot to really digest here. I feel like Seven of Pentacles with the sunflowers is like somebody needs to really take a look at everything that's happened. This kind of gives me like judgment vibes, you know, review everything that's happened. Hierophant also means like wise counsel. Like this person could be getting advice about coming towards you, even though they're in another connection. But I'm getting here with the Ace of Cups. They're ready to start a new relationship with you. Look at that, Three of Cups. Okay, so they're wanting to be in this celebratory mood, happy energy with you. And that's what they've been thinking about. And that's why they're taking their time, because it's not an overnight decision. But I feel like your masculine's in this energy where he's making plans, making changes here with the Hierophant. Why is Eight of Cups here? The Five of Pentacles. This one's very interesting. I was actually noticing it when I was shuffling, because this is a bride that's being shut out, left out of the church. And this reflection, it's like a couple looking at each other and she's on the outside looking in. So this is like third party. Okay. So if your person is married to this karmic, she knows she's on the outside looking into you guys, into your connection. And it's no accident here that the Three of Pentacles are in the frame here with you guys, and this is a Two of Pentacles on the outside. So I feel like she feels shut out of this connection, especially with the Eight of Cups. I mean, that's double confirmation. Somebody is moving away from a karmic that they're married to. And this is something that has been building and growing in this love. This person finally realized that they're ready to walk away from this karmic energy. Look at that, Knight of Cups at the bottom. Okay, there's a horse again, interesting. This is like a fountain. I feel like your person's realizing their emotions are coming to the surface and they can't control it, because it's like a fountain that just keeps flowing with all this emotions, with all these emotions. And I feel like your person's realizing, I don't want to invest any more into this connection with this karmic and I want to move out. You know, for some of you, I don't feel like they live together. Okay. They could be separated. Why is the Eight of Swords here? Or they could just be sleeping in different rooms, you know? But she definitely feels this, that he's already pulling away. I didn't even know this reading was going to be like this, okay? Look at that, Nine of Cups. So I feel like your person wants to break away from this negative thinking. It's a lot of snowflakes here too. So this is right now in this winter energy. But if you notice, in this card, she has the key wrapped around her neck. And it matches that lock. So I feel like your person knows that they have the solution. I mean, that's why we started the reading with think of a solution out of this darkness, because that's exactly what this is. Coming up with a solution in your thoughts, that you're not stuck, that you have the ability to cleanse yourself, clear your energy. That's why we saw the release your ex card, clear your energy, right? Water is about healing and clearing, purging this energy. The writing's on the wall, okay? And you know, in this one, we actually have eight cups on the wall. So I feel like your person knows they need to walk away. If they want to have their wish fulfillment and love themselves, they need to walk away from this karmic. Like, the writing's on the wall. They see it, okay? Yeah, see? Five of Cups. They need to bury this connection once and for all, because it's not growing. It's not bearing any fruit anymore. It has been a very daunting and draining type of connection. Your person has no more fuel left in them to continue this with this karmic. They just don't. And that's why the reading started off with release your ex. This is codependency energy. And yeah. I mean, that's what's coming through here, you guys. Let's just get some oracle cards and we'll get some initials. And we'll wrap up the reading with the months. Wow. Pop up. So yeah, I feel like somebody is going to be spontaneous and come up out of nowhere to surprise you. Feminine, this is sticking out. Wow, your twin flame. Yep. Your twin flame, your masculine, is going to pop up and come towards you, because you guys feel the same towards each other. You guys are kindred spirits. You guys can't get enough of each other. Unquenchable, wanting more, insatiable. You guys are yearning and longing for this connection that only you and your masculine know that you can satisfy each other's thirst. You know what I mean? Like, quench that thirst. Wow. Look at that, pretending. Fake, living beyond means. I also get here with that energy is that your person knows that finances are not what's most important, because that's just a comfort level where, you know, you're just living beyond your means, and that's when you need to readjust your budget sort of thing. Because if you're spread too thin each paycheck and you're holding on to every penny you have, then you're living beyond your means. You're not balanced. You're just trying to keep yourself from going under, but it's like out of control. It's not, you're not being prepared for anything that could come up out of nowhere. You know what I mean? Like, you're not saving money. You're just spending your energy where you can, but it's not sustainable to live that way. And I feel like your person's tired of pretending that they can live in this energy relying on material things. And it's funny because I had a dream about shoes the other day, where somebody was trying to steal something and then they put it back because they knew they were going to get caught. I don't know. I just always feel like messages are, you know, dreams are messages. And I feel like your person is finally feeling like they were trying to steal time, in a way, is what I'm getting here. They were trying to pretend that this is where they needed to be, Remember how we started the reading with strangers? But now they're realizing that this connection is fake because they don't feel like they even know this person. Look at that. They feel like they're in a lockbox. They feel like they're trapped with this person that they don't really feel that they're home with. Closed in, trapped, frustrated. So your person's very frustrated being in this pretend energy. They're tired of pretending that they want to make this work with this karmic when the whole time everything in them tells them they want to come visit you. And look at this. This is at the bottom. Irreconcilable differences, divorce, final. Okay. So very obvious here that this person is not feeling free in this love that they're in this connection that they're in. They're feeling trapped. That's why we have the Eight of Swords as the overall energy. But they have the key. They have the key to unlock themselves. You see how it says SOS? They know that they have help. The universe is helping them realize this, that you're not locked in. You're only keeping yourself locked because you think you're stuck, but you're not. This also popped up. Reminiscing memories returning. Okay, we saw the Six of Cups earlier. So I feel like your person is thinking about you, and they're thinking about returning. Look, right underneath that, we had on the table, offer, proposal, commitment. I mean, your person is thinking and reminiscing about your connection. You know, they really want to give you an offer. This is why we have the Hierophant here too. They want to come back out of nowhere and actually offer you something. Look at that. This is at the top of the deck. Cleansing. Did I not say earlier with what Spirit said about clearing your energy? Release your ex. So I feel like your person knows they have to clear this karmic energy, complete this contract with the karmic before they can come to you. Removing negativity out of their life. Because this is why this was the overall energy. Because now they realize you're their true love. Wow. Look at that. That came up at the top of the deck. Because they know time is of the essence right now. And they're keeping these feelings that they have for you in the down low. They are like extremely attracted to you. And it's interesting that we have two keys here. So I feel like your person knows that you are the key to helping them clear out this energy. It's almost like they're going to use you as a motivation to get their act together and know that the time is ticking right now. They need to take action and end this connection with the Five of Cups that we saw earlier. Look at that. We had the Magician right underneath that and the Tower. Okay, so this is definitely saying here that this person is going to manifest a new beginning and destroy what doesn't need to come along with them. I feel like for the new year, your person is clearing house here. They're cleaning house. Okay, let's just see. Let's get a couple more here before we get to the initials. Look at that. They're thinking about you and your memories. This is another card here confirming what we just saw, the memories. Reminiscing, keepsake, perception, learn from the past, make memories. Yeah, I feel like your person is thinking about your connection, really wanting to make new memories. Oh my God, bottom of the deck we have engagement ring. Engagement, partnership, commitment, eternity, completion, union. Remember how I said I feel like your person feels you balance them out? I feel like this is confirmation here. They feel like you guys complete each other in the most perfect way. And when they're without you, they feel this energy even more. Okay. What else, Spirit? Self-indulgence. Focus on self, self-worth, time to heal, shadow work, self-appreciation. Okay. This reminded me of earlier where I was saying your person has put a lot of emphasis in the material world of feeling worthy with money and career, making those things like define them and their character. And at the end of the day, those things are not important as far as what it makes you out to be. Look at that, heart with the key. welcoming love, meeting the one, open your heart, getting together, perfect, okay? So we saw that Eight of Swords earlier with the girl with the lock, and it was in the shape of a heart, and here's another confirmation. I feel like your person knows that they need to work on themselves, they need to heal, do some shadow work. That's why we started the reading with that dark energy of the deep sea mermaid. Somebody's going to the depths of their psyche here of figuring out why they're always in this negative energy and purge that energy and lock themselves out of that tunnel vision is what I'm getting here. You know, look at that bottom of the deck cassette. Outdated thinking, exactly. Conditioning, replaying events over in your head. So yeah, I feel like your person is ready to turn over a new leaf here. They're ready to stop thinking that things have to be a certain way. This is why the Hierophant is here too, because this is about finally breaking away from old beliefs, old tradition, old ways of doing things. This is why the Tower is here too. This is about destroying the old foundation and accepting a new way of life, a new concept, a new lifestyle even. Wow. Look at that. Underneath that, we have coffee cup. Meeting and conversing, savoring the moment, feeling uplifted friendship, okay? So yeah, I feel like your person really wants to get together. That's why we saw offer on the table. They want to meet with you. They want to be in the present moment, not be relying on the past anymore. Yeah, I feel like especially with how this came out with cassette, they're tired of replaying that same old tape over in their head. They want to make new memories with you. They want to really be committed, but they want to start off with the friendship first. You know, they're going to chase you too, the chaser. Okay, fear of abandonment issue. I feel like your person does not want to lose you, okay? That's definitely what's coming through here. So, let's pull some cards, letters, and numbers to see what spirit wants you to know. We have a you, okay? Wow, we have a yes. Okay, so if you've been thinking about a question, Spirit wants you to know the answer is yes. We have the letter B here at the bottom. Okay. Number 9. So 9's about an ending. So I feel like Spirit is saying, yes, something is ending here. Letter at the bottom here is G. Wow. We have A, okay? We have G again at the bottom. And then these wanted to come out. R, V. Interesting. U, R, V. I feel like this is kind of saying like you are victorious. Maybe your name is Victor, Victoria, Vicky. Oh, wow. B again at the bottom. So, yeah, I feel like I just heard the word beautiful, and especially since I heard the word, I saw the card Beauty and the Beast. For some of you, you could be named Belle or Bella. And we have H here. I don't know why I heard the word hotel. Maybe your name is Harry, Henry. I don't know. Wow, right when I said that we have E, Henry. Oh, wow, and then we have X at the bottom. Hex, I feel like somebody is breaking out of some kind of spell that they were under. And that could be the codependency energy. Now we have the letter M at the bottom. Mex, somebody could be Mexican. But yeah, the word X, release your X. We saw that here in the reading. Vax, like vaccinated. Somebody recently got vaccinated. That could be confirmation. Rex could be another word here too. RV, like they travel a lot. They could have an RV. Take it how it resonates, guys. Axe could be like somebody's cutting somebody off, especially with the number 9 here. 9 could be for September too. So the months that we got March. February came out first, so February, March. That's like in the springtime. Something could be very significant about that. Let's get one more month. Kind of getting some of you might be a Pisces or an Aries. Wow, now we have September. Did I not say 9 for September? And here we have confirmation. Underneath that, we have May. So we have September and May. So I feel like next year, something could be brewing in the springtime all the way till the end of the summer here. But I feel like with the cherry blossom tree, it's like the river is flowing here. A lot of emotions are going to come out. And Spirit is saying yes, like something good is going to come out where you're going to get a yes, or something that you've been waiting for is going to come out into fruition here. Something's going to blow over here in February during the winter time. Something that is ending, something that was dead that's coming back to life. And we saw the Six of Cups. I feel like there's going to be a reunion here. A reconciliation. Love it. So that is your reading, guys. I hope that was helpful. Comment below. Let me know if this reading resonated. If you'd like to book a reading with me, you can do so by clicking on my link below. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye.